This is the Casio G-Shock G-200 series watch, introduced almost two decades ago, that is in the year 2001 at a price of 17,000 Japanese yen. At that price and at that time, was it worth it? Totally, simply because if you look over here, the watch is still up and running, even up to date, and that shows quality even when it is mostly just resin or plastic. But the real question is, it is still worth it today? Also yes, because if you're planning on getting one, you're only gonna end up paying like 10 to 30 bucks, which is incredibly cheap. And it has better constructions even to the, if I'm not mistaken, the siblings to this watch called the G100 series. And even if you compare this watch for 30 bucks to any entry level Casio watch out there, this is still much better. Granted, there's a trade-off, of course. The design is old. Just by looking at it, you know right away this is a vintage category. And it is not as popular as any of those Casio or modern G-Shock, and the size is pretty bulky as well. The lug-to-lug distance would be from here to here, right? Around 50.3 millimeters. The width size from this side to this side to 47.4, if I'm not mistaken. The thickness will be 15.7 millimeters, and the overall watch will weigh you 72 grams, which is fair, even though it has metal at the front. And if you are okay with the bulkiness of it, then you are in for a surprise, because this G-Shock watch also have a one big feature that is also fun at the same time, which is also really cool, and that is the LED backlighting, which will glows in red colorway. The red LED light alone is the main reason why I bought this G-Shock watch in the first place, and I don't think Casio will be adding the same feature on modern G-Shock. So if you want something fun, something different like this, vintage G-Shock watches is the way to go. Also, I have to point out, if you pick up the other color variants, this is the red out of all five. If you pick the blue or the black one, I can't recall which ones, you have different color LED as well. So this one is really, really cool series. It's because of the sharp indices in there, and also of the sharp and 12, 3 and 9 minute marker. It looks really like a vampire fang of some kind. It looks much better. It blends really well with the colorway as well. So this red and silver version is way better, even though I wish this body came in gloss black like on one of these. But silver is, well, that's okay. Okay, now, I have to be clear, aside from the LED backlight just now, the rest is pretty normal, like any entry-level NADG models. But anyway, let's have a quick run on all of them, right? First, the obvious, you have a metal guard resin bezel at the front, fine finishing, gloss finishing around here, and this one is mineral crystal. The movement has anti-magnetic structure, and obviously, like an G-Shock, 200 meters water resistance and shock resisting structure. You could also see a graph over here. They even print out the result from the testing to show how good this watch is at absorbing shocks. Basically, there's a two wave and that's done. Very efficient. Now, if you move on the sides, there's the minute marker or minutes indicator around there, alongside with button indicator as well. There's the hand adjustment button, mode selection button, light on button, and this will be on or off or starter stop from the stopwatch mode. That's it. In the face, it is in red colorway matte finishing, and it has some kind of texture at the front, I believe to match with the one on the watch band, which also look incredibly sporty to match with the sharp ends on the indices as well. Now move back to the watch band. It has a bone structure over here at the center and traction pattern at the top, and this combinations, the sharp end, the sporty hour and minute hands, this textured watch band, leather material, all reminds me of the Casio 80s watches, which if I'm not mistaken was released a year prior to this one. So I have a feeling that might come into influence to the design of the watch, and that's why it looks the way it is. But how does it work? To be fair, it works similar to the G100 series watch. If you own one of those, you have a rough idea of how inconvenient this watch is, but let's have a quick rundown. Okay, now at hometown, it is showing me time in analog format, hour and minute, then one second hands. Oh, by the way, I almost forgot, the tip of the hour and minute hands could glow in the dark, but it's really useless, so that's why you didn't see it in the LED shots just now. Anyway, the digital display in positive will show me day date, and that is all. If you want to have digital time, press mode button. Now you have it. You could set it up, of course, using the adjust button down here, if I'm not mistaken. I'm sorry, the one over here is just. And next, you'll have alarm, a single alarm, no snooze, no signal, just basically daily alarm. And then you'll have a stopwatch. Here is pretty cool. It has one of 100 seconds precision stopwatch to a 24 hour range, but you don't have split time or target time. Check this out. Stop. Start, that's it. Stop it again. If you want to reset this to zero, use the same button. Press and hold, reset it back to zero. Last mode will bring us into the dual time. So this works similarly like the digital time just now. You could set it up to be your local time, the analog will be world time, anyone you like, and just set it up, so easy. Now back to home time keeping. That will summarize all of the functions that this model has. Aside from that, you do have the 12 to 24 time format, the battery life will last you for 3 years, and manual hand adjustment over here, which I also have to demonstrate. If you want to make sure the hand match to this time down here, press this hand setting button. There you go, that is how it works. It is really slow, really convenient, and if I want to match this 1140 just down here, yeah, check this out. I have to wait the hands to move all the way around to hit these positions. I cannot go backwards. It works like a crown on the Swiss style watches, except it is not as convenient because you cannot move in both directions, only one directions, and it moves at a constant speed like that, which is really, really time consuming, and I don't like that. But Casio seems to be still using this movement on modern G-Shock, even modern Energigi Casio watches as well. So probably because of the simplicity of it, it is still relevant, and that one of the reasons that makes this watch indestructible. Just guess. Other thing I need to point out is the mid-size button. Even though it is big, it is slippery and pretty hard to use because the guard is too big. And the good thing that I just find out is the watch adapter over here. It has a 16mm lug like most G-Shock watch, but it convert it to a 22mm band. So looking for parts is a lot easier. And it had a center cut out to 12mm. It is only locked with spring bar, both of this side on this side. And the rest is pretty much straightforward. The whole watch is made in Thailand. And final thoughts, I have to say, is this the watch for you? No, not really. If you want to buy this as your first G-Shock, I wouldn't recommend this at all, even though it is cheap, but I mean there's so many better options out there just because of that. But if you already have everything else, every other good G-Shock out there, so this will be a nice addition to add in your collections, and mainly because of the red LED backlighting just now. That is so much fun.